So this is a relatively new thing in my life. On a Monday, Wednesday and Friday, I now set my alarm for 6:30 before anyone else in the house has woken up, and I come downstairs and do a workout. The little reward that I give myself after doing the workout when the house is still quiet, there's no one else around, is around 20 minutes or so, uninterrupted, to drink my coffee and go through your YouTube comments. All right, have a good day, guys.
Bye.
All right, just me and you left then, boys. These days, I love Fridays. You know, it's got them weekend feels incoming, so everyone's in a better mood. My wife Claire doesn't work on Fridays, so we get to go on a date night and on F1 weekends.
Well, I really appreciate being able to watch the F1 practice sessions from the comfort of my own sofa. That wasn't always the case.
Verpy's getting this shootout. Is it a shootout?
So, free practice one is underway, but delayed because the medical helicopter cannot land at the local hospital. So that means that everybody in the garages is standing around, kind of doing nothing, just waiting. And so it feels like this is a good moment to talk about why I love F1 practices and F1 Fridays from here on my sofa today, as opposed to what I used to feel about F1 Fridays years ago when I was in one of those garages. Because Fridays for an F1 mechanic, well, they're the worst day, really, of the entire weekend, because it's just a proper hard slog. There's no winning or losing at the end of it. There's just pounding round and round, doing lap after lap. And doing lap after lap, putting mileage on your F1 car, translates into more work for the mechanics and those people in the garage. There's more servicing required of components. There's more risk of things getting damaged or broken or a car being crashed. And those things all add on to what is already a very, very long Friday at work for those guys. So, whilst I loved every second of my time at the team, I also really appreciate being able to watch it all from right here. Having said that, when you get a time like this, a delay during a practice session, on one hand, it's great because you minimise all those risks and all those additional hours of work that I've just been mentioning here. But it's also frustrating because you've done all the prep, you've done all the build up to a race weekend, you've got up early on your Friday, you've come in at the time the curfew opens up to allow you back in, everything's going, the adrenaline's pumping, you're ready. And then it's a case of, right, just wait. And it's boring, there is nothing to do. You start eating through the snacks that are in the garage, you start cleaning your tools or reorganizing your tool tray, but ultimately, although the last thing you really want to do is piling up the risk and piling up the workload, equally, once you're there, once you're committed to it, you just want to get on with it. So the guys and girls in the pit lane right now, I'm sure, will be frustrated. And don't forget, this is being treated almost like a new circuit. So from a team's perspective, they need data. They need to get the cars out there to see what these modern 2020 cars will look like out on a circuit, an old school track like the Nurburgring in the modern era, and just see what they've got, what these simulations have predicted and how well they correlate to real world cars on a real world track. The only way to find that out is to get them out there. I mean, don't get me wrong, I've still got plenty to do in between practice sessions. Now, Fridays on an F1 weekend involve a huge amount of routine. You go through a set routine in terms of your run plan, more or less. You go through a certain amount of routine in terms of preparation for the car, work in between sessions on the car, that kind of thing. I'm gonna have my own routines these days, but they're very, very different. Part of it involves going for a run in between sessions, which I'm about to go and do. But with FP1 being entirely wiped out due to the weather, it puts a huge amount of importance on FP2, and that routine that would have been spread across both sessions of the Friday will have to be condensed into just the most important elements to get them done in FP2, if the weather holds out. Well, I finished my run, but as the rain starts to pour down here, I'm going to go and check out what's happening in Germany. So, practice sessions are over, and yet nobody turned a wheel. My routine is pretty easy these days. I can be utterly flexible about what I do and when I do it in the most part. Some things, of course, got to get done. But Formula One teams, well, they're very, very good at adapting and rejigging schedules and achieving goals with a new set of parameters. And that is what they've got after today. Two practice sessions down, no running, leaving just FP3 to do all the work they hope to do over the course of all of Friday and Saturday morning. So like earlier when I said after FP1 they would have to reassess what the priorities were to learn through FP2. Well, now that's gone as well, so the whole of Friday now needs to be condensed into just 1 hour long session on Saturday morning. It means that the teams back at base in the simulators have very little data or very little new data to play with. It means the engineering meetings will now be focused on rejigging or coming up with a brand new run plan to come up with the most important critical factors. They'll have to forget testing new parts, signing off new components, and actually spend all of FP3 just simply learning about how they prepare the car for qualifying in the race in what will almost certainly be very cold and wet conditions. It's going to be a busy hour if we get running tomorrow morning, but I tell you what, if you think about the F1 mechanics and engineers in the pit lane having a bit of a night off, having nothing to do, you couldn't be further from the truth. The cars still come apart, the engines come out and put the race engines in, the race gearboxes go on, all the components that were built and set up ready for Friday, most of them won't be any good for Saturday or Sunday. They're not race-ready components. Lots of that will have been test items. Some drivers or some cars were set up for drivers that won't even be in them tomorrow. Big shout out to Mick Schumacher and Callum Ilott, who never got the chance to turn a wheel in their first ever race weekend Formula One experience. Hopefully they'll get another shot. But it'll be a busy night as ever in the pit lane, but tomorrow morning things are going to really get serious and it will be busier than ever. Let's hope the weather improves. They can get on with their routines. I'm going to get on with mine. I'm going out on a date night now, so I'll see you later. And I know, I need a haircut. That's another routine that's fallen by the wayside in 2020.